Welcome to Desktop Deployment Essentials, our new series to help you prepare for your shift to Windows 10 and Office 365 ProPlus. In the next few minutes, I'll walk through step 6 in our recommended deployment process wheel, options for deploying your operating system images, and upgrades using your preferred tools. Now, whether you're planning for bare metal deployment, PC refresh, or replacement, in-place upgrade, or a combination of these, we'll cover all of your options. Now, if you've been following the deployment process wheel till now, you've at least partially completed the steps for device and app readiness, prepared your infrastructure, configured and collected app packages, have a plan in place for migrating user files and configuring default user settings, as well as have plans for retaining your existing security controls and perhaps deploying some new ones. Now we've arrived at the stage where you're putting all of these pieces together to automate as much as you can to install Windows 10 and Office 365 ProPlus, along with all the necessary drivers, apps, and whatever else is needed. Ultimately, the best measure of success is meeting user expectations and avoiding disruptions in their work. And in this step, you'll start testing and deploying to pilot users as part of your phased deployment. Now, one tip here, before you broaden deployment, you'll need to skip ahead to step 8 in our deployment process wheel, and that's about user communications and training. Most organizations use the process of PC imaging to configure and capture a clone of Windows, including a base set of standard apps that are pre-installed, or even a thinner image where you only put in application runtimes and updates. Now, the best way to do this is by using a virtual machine for this process to avoid any unexpected driver-related compatibility issues and for automation purposes. Now, if you're going the image capture route, we also recommend automating as much as possible to ensure the best quality image and a repeatable process. Now, for most deployments, it's best to put as little customization and apps as possible into the Windows image prior to capturing. This is what we call a thin image approach, which can save overall bandwidth on the network by eliminating the number of apps that are attached to the image. And by starting with a thin base image, you can also layer in required apps, languages, configurations, and those can be dynamically tailored to users. Now, during the build and capture process, tools like System Center Configuration Manager and the Microsoft Deployment Toolkit use a System Preparation Tool, or SysPrep, along with the generalized command to reseal your image before they capture the Windows 10 installation as an image. The captured image will have the Windows image or WIM file format like standard Windows installation media. Now, once you have your custom WIM file, you can also use another task sequence as part of an OS deployment in System Center Configuration Manager or Microsoft Deployment Toolkit to perform deployment-related tasks to apply the image and run tasks both before and after the Windows image is applied. Now, with your custom image ready, the installation or migration type will fall into the following categories. First, bare metal deployment. Now, this is the scenario used to deploy an image to a clean disk or where you re-image a computer where you don't intend to keep any of the data on the disk. Second, and similar to bare metal, is computer refresh. The key difference here is that user state either remains on the disk or will be restored after the installation is complete. And last is computer replacement. Here, as the name implies, you're replacing a PC with another PC. In this case, there's often a backup of user files from the first PC to a central location, then a restore of those files back to a second PC. Now, all of these scenarios have something in common. They use a task sequence to run, and a custom image can be applied each time. Now, let's talk about a brand new option available for the first time as a Config Manager task sequence with Windows 10, InPlace Upgrade. InPlace Upgrade from a previous version of Windows does not require a task sequence to execute, though it is recommended that you use one. Now, InPlace Upgrade does not allow you to apply a custom image with applications pre-installed, but you can update the default install.wim using offline servicing. For example, you might want to make sure it has the latest Windows updates applied prior to performing upgrades. InPlace Upgrade uses Windows Setup. The setup engine runs several small pre-installation checks looking for known compatibility issues. It also preserves the user state and applications and only removes what isn't compatible with the version of Windows that's being installed. With this option, previously installed applications and user state are preserved. The InPlace Upgrade scenario can be used to migrate to Windows 10 from legacy versions of Windows, as well as upgrade from older versions of Windows 10. Now, one more thing. After Windows Setup completes the upgrade, your task sequence can continue to run and upgrade applications like Office. Now, let's talk about phased deployment. As you're planning your deployment, you'll be targeting computers for bare metal refresh, replace, and upgrade paths. The recommended approach here in this case is to use phased rollouts to collections of similar machines. This way, you can validate compatibility, delivery, automation, user acceptance, network bandwidth consumption, and other factors before increasing the scale of your deployment. Now, regardless of the deployment type you choose, you'll want to make sure it's as automated as possible for predictability and reliability. Microsoft offers two solutions to automate OS deployment using automated task sequences. System Center Configuration Manager provides built-in operating system deployment capabilities to complement its capabilities for software distribution and software update management. Now, Config Manager is widely used by organizations of all sizes and supports all four Windows deployment types. Optionally, you can integrate Config Manager with Microsoft Intune to add additional capabilities for deployment and device management. And one other deployment option is the free Microsoft Deployment Toolkit, or MDT, which is typically used by small and medium-sized organizations for OS deployment. This requires very little infrastructure. MDT integrates with Windows Deployment Services, or WDS, for network boot, and it supports all four deployment types as well, and can install applications, drivers, and settings. And of course, MDT can even be integrated with Config Manager. Now, our last option, new with Windows 10, is to configure new PCs as part of your hardware refresh cycle using Windows Autopilot. Here, you can work with supporting hardware vendors to customize the default Windows setup experience, for example, by eliminating options presented to users, like licensing agreements or telemetry settings. Then, when a user signs into the PC during setup using their Azure AD credentials, the device enrolls into Microsoft Intune, which can then take over the deployment process and apply applications, software updates, and configurations, and compliance policies. Windows Autopilot can also optionally prevent the user from accessing the first session until provisioning is complete. So that was a run through of your OS deployment scenarios and how you can use your tools to automate the process at scale. The task sequencing engines that you use also apply as you roll out Windows 10 and optionally the Office 365 ProPlus semi-annual updates. We saw how Windows Autopilot can modernize provisioning of new PCs coming directly from hardware suppliers. Next up on the deployment process wheel, we'll explain your options for keeping current with updates in the new Windows and Office as a Service model. And to learn more, visit our Modern Desktop Deployment Center and keep following our Desktop Deployment Essentials series here on Microsoft Mechanics. Thanks for watching.